The focus of today's war strategy, reaching the unreachable, and the scripture will be Romans chapter 2, verses 11 through 16. And it says, "For there is no respect of persons with God, for as many as have sinned without law shall also perish without law, and as many as have sinned in the law shall be judged by the law. For not the hearers of the law are just before God, but the doers of the law shall be justified. For when the Gentiles, which have not the law, do by nature the things contained in the law, these having not the law are a law unto themselves, which show the work of the law written in their hearts, their conscience also bearing witness, and their thoughts, the mean, while accusing or else excusing one another, in a day when God shall judge the secrets of men by Jesus Christ according to my gospel." The strategy. The Lord does not recognize a person by their nationality, culture, gender, ethnicity, nor skin color. For every human soul that walks this earth was first the Lord's before they were birthed into this world. Because of the corruption produced by Satan in this fallen earth, the soul birthed into the world in pure innocence becomes molded and crafted into a vessel of death until the power of the blood of Jesus Christ makes them a new creation. The power of the cross destroyed the work of Satan, in which he exercised through sin and death, once and for all. The remote regions of the world where many of our lost brothers and sisters have not heard the gospel are now receiving a special grace that shall open up their hearts for the Lord to manifest himself to deliver to them and deliver the message of salvation, as has been the testimonies in many Muslims in the Middle East. Although they, those in isolated regions and also in captivities of many form, may not know the law of God, for no one ever traveled to these unreachable regions to preach to them, for one reason or another, the power of the cross has made it possible for the moral law of God to dwell within their hearts, where they can exercise this new freedom and opportunity of pure love, or reject it by a sinful heart, thus perishing apart from the written law. The Lord is just in all his ways and merciful in accounting for those who never had a chance to hear the gospel. Our prayers are crucial in opening up the spiritual path for God's gospel to shine in the hearts of these lost sheep, constrained in various forms of isolation and captivity. When the Lord comes to judge the world, it will not be on what the outer man displayed to the world. No. Instead, he shall judge the secrets of our hearts, in which we are all held accountable on equal grounds to. This is what shall be weighed on the scale of judgment. Woe be unto us if we who have the gospel and are found wanting on that day. Let us pray. Father, we pray for all of our brothers and sisters, our lost brothers and sisters in the remote regions of the world, those who go unprayed for, Father. We pray for them right now, for many of them have not heard the gospel message, and many of us cannot traverse those terrains, oh God. We cannot make it to the Amazons. We cannot make it to the islands that is in isolation that has never heard of your gospel. We can't make it to places in the Middle East, Father, to spread your gospel message. We can't be there in the physical realm, oh God, in flesh, Father. We cannot be there in body. But if this one way that we could be there, Father, is in spirit, we could speak our words, Father, from the very positions that we are in right now, from the very territories, from the very grounds in which you have established for us. And then our words, Father, would begin to traverse through the atmosphere, Father. It would begin to traverse through the airways in the spiritual realm, that angels, Father, would begin to receive our prayer, O God, that you had deemed to be acceptable before you. And they shall carry this message over to the four corners of the earth, O God, to cover those, O God, who are going unprayed for right now, to the lost souls, O Lord, to those who are victims of trafficking, who has never heard of the gospel message, to the children, oh God, who is being sold into slavery, has never heard of the gospel message, to the people in pagan nations, oh God, that has false gods that are in operation that never heard of your gospel. And so right now, God, you said in your word, oh God, we said in the book of Romans, oh Lord, and I speak these words, Father, for you says that You said right here, Father, for when the Gentiles, which have not the law, do by nature the things contained in the law, these having not the law are a law unto themselves. This right here, Father, is a mighty grace in which you are outpouring upon the Gentiles, O God, upon the many people who has never heard of you, O Lord, who never heard of Christianity, who never heard of the power of the cross, O God, of which you did for us on the cross. Right now, Father, you are putting right here in your word that you are releasing a supernatural grace upon those who have never heard of your gospel. In which that those who have the law written upon their hearts, the law of love, in which you're seeking your people, O God, they become a law unto themselves, in which they shall be judged by the moral law that you see fit through your eyes, by the outpouring of grace, in which you are qualified to do, first because you are God, and second because this is the power of the cross in the name of Jesus. For this is the power of the cross in which you have poured forth to redeem the world. For you said, Father, that you have died for all men for all time, not just for those who will hear the gospel, but for those who have not heard the gospel. For, Father, the power of the cross was to remove sin from the world. And when sin was removed from the world, the power of death in which Satan had and his grasp has been destroyed. He no longer has power to keep these victims in captivity, O God. Because of the power of the cross, O God, sin has been removed from east, from as far east it is to the west, O God, and that from as far as north it is from the south, O God, that sin is annihilated. And so you're calling forth your people, O God, who knows the power of the cross, to begin to start interceding for these lost souls, for those, Father, who are, like I said before, who are suffering because they are trafficking victims, O God, because they have been forced into prostitution, they have been forced into slavery, and just those in the remote islands, O God, who just never heard of the gospel message. Right now, Father, in this gospel, in this verse, Father, in this strategy, O Lord, saying that there is a supernatural grace that is released upon these people, where the moral law will be written upon their hearts. And we pray, oh God, and that this that this moral law of love, your love, written upon their house, upon their hearts, oh God, there will be a supernatural outpouring that takes place right now upon their hearts. And the reason why is because when your love begins to pour upon their hearts, oh God, and they begin to start loving their neighbors as themselves, and begin to start loving all those who are around them, this opens up an opportunity, Father, for you to manifest yourself before them. And so this is what's been happening in the Middle East, is that many people, oh God, in which we have been praying for, many people in which the martyrs have died for, oh God, because of the fact that their hearts are being softened by your love, by your grace and mercy, Father, this is the opportunity, that's the doorway that opens up for you to manifest yourself, oh God, and then you can send, and you can go there and begin to preach the gospel to them, and they shall be saved in the name of Jesus. So right now, Father, we pray for a holy hedge of protection, a supernatural outpouring, Father, and a holy fire to come down from heaven upon the hearts of those, Father, in these remote regions and these territories of oppression where they cannot even know who Jesus is, oh God. We thank you so much for this strategy, and we're going to speak this scripture once again into the atmosphere, oh God. For you said, for as many as have sinned without law shall also perish without law, and as many as have sinned in the law shall be judged by the law. So you're saying, Father, that there is justice being served on both sides of the front. There is justice being served for those who never knew the law, oh God. And there's justice being served for those who knew you and your commandments and did not keep it. And you go on to say, Father, for not the hearers of the law are just before God, but the doers of the law shall be justified. So that means that even if a person hears the gospel or do not hear the gospel because of the situation that they're in, oh God, he's saying that those who do the law, the moral law, the law of love, Father, for this is what the Ten Commandments reflects, Father, is the law of love, is that those who are doing these things shall be justified. So because of the fact that those who are doing these things shall be justified, because they're living by the law of love, that means there's a supernatural grace being extended onto those who never even heard of the Ten Commandments, who never even heard of what you did for us on the cross, oh God. And so we're praying right now, Father, for a supernatural outpouring. Father, begin to dispatch your angels, begin to start putting the hedge of protection from the enemy from going in to destroy the mighty work that you're about to do. And we pray, Father, for all the strongholds, oh God, all the strongholds that the enemy has set up, O Lord, that is unauthorized building, Father, unauthorized armaments, unauthorized fortresses, O God. We call for holy missiles from heaven to come down and begin to destroy the strongholds of the enemy, to demolish the plans and the strongholds in which they had. We claim these territories, O God, that has been filled with darkness for many years, O God, to your kingdom of light in the name of Jesus. We bind up every generational curse. We bind up every spirit of lawlessness that's operating in the jungle, and we bind them up and cast them into the pit of hell, Father, in accordance with Matthew chapter 18:18, and we loose, oh God, your word. We loose your love. We loose your mercy. We loose your grace. We loose the power. We loose the power of the cross upon these souls, and that they shall be delivered. For you're going to say, Father, that for when the Gentiles which have not the law do by nature the things contained in the law, these having not the law are a law unto themselves, which show the work of the law written in their hearts. And this is the heart matter, because your law, Father, is a law of the heart. And it says that their conscience also bearing witness in their thoughts, the meanwhile accusing or else excusing one another. In the name of Jesus, we thank you so much, Father, in which we could touch and agree upon this prayer. And so we know right now, Father, that soon and very soon there's going to be a supernatural outpouring and breakthrough in these regions that people never even heard of or thought there's going to be a breakthrough. We pray you shall protect the revival that shall go forth this day. And it's in Jesus' name we pray, our Father. Amen. Who shall I fear? You crush the enemy underneath my feet. You are my sword and shield. Though troubles linger still, whom shall I fear? I know who goes before me. Always by my side.